Welcome to my channel.
Beware. Tapeworm eggs may be hiding in your salad. Tennis player Leander Paesbrought neurocysticercosis to the front page headlines when he suddenly fell ill in 2003. Doctors found a single cyst of a tapeworm in his brain when he complained of severe headaches just before blacking out. The parasitic infection, commonly referred to as worm in the brain, is back in the news with a 17-year-old city shuttler, Nihar Thacker, passing away on Wednesday after suffering complications associated with the condition. Thacker suffered epileptic fits for the first time on Sunday before passing out in a trial room of a mall in Lower Peril. The worm usually makes its way into the patient's gut through pork that hasn't been properly cooked or through vegetable and fruit salads that haven't been washed properly. The tapeworm eggs in the food travel from the gut to any part of the body. When they reach the brain, the condition is called neurocysticercosis, said Dr. Sangeeta Rabot, who heads Chem Hospital's neurology department. Thacker was diagnosed with neurocysticercosis after he was brought in a critical condition to Global Hospital in Peril by his parents on Sunday. He had suffered one or many seizures when he was in the trial room, said Dr. Nitin Sampat, one of the doctors treating Thacker. When the door was broken open sometime later, the teenager was found with his face down and a bruise on his forehead. Dr. Sampat, however, takes pain to explain that neurocysticercosis isn't usually life-threatening. In this case, there was a long period when the oxygen supply to the patient's brain was cut off due to the seizures. Moreover, he added, the advent of MRI and CT scans have made diagnosis easy. Treatment usually is a two-week-long course of medicines. In the worst cases, there are numerous cysts in the brain. People should not brush off any unusual headaches or jerks. That slight tightening of a hand or unusual movement of the lips could be a kind of epileptic fit, he said. In fact, Dr. Rabot said neurocysticercosis is the leading cause for epilepsy in India. Over 30% of the symptomatic epilepsy cases occur due to neurocysticercosis, said neurosurgeon Dr. Parash Doshi. There is also a socioeconomic angle here. In Kashmir, where pork is not consumed, the incidence of neurocysticercosis is low. It is also low in Kerala, which has higher levels of education. Meanwhile, on Thursday, a few shuttlers, who train under coach Mangesh Palekar, observed a two-minute silence in memory of Thacker, their training partner. They were disturbed by his sudden death, said Palekar. He trained here regularly for more than 8 years and had a great rapport with fellow badminton players. Thacker took up the sport after watching his father Sandeep play at the Hindu Gymkhana. He wanted to play and would insist every day, said his father. So, I put him under Leroy Tsa, who is a coach at the Hindu Gym. He learned basics of the game under me, said Tsa. But as there were not enough boys playing regularly here, I advised his father to send him to Mathunga Gymkhana, where he could get sufficient partners at a coaching session under Palekar. Thacker, who won a bronze and later a silver medal in the under-16 category at the inter-school badminton tourney organized by the Mumbai School Sports Association, was playing for Mumbai District in U17 category when he suddenly passed away. It is a big loss for Mumbai badminton, says Palekar. He was one of the promising talents. He would have certainly represented the state.